Good morning. Please stand as we begin our celebration.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Dear brothers and sisters, since the beginning of Lent until now, we have prepared our hearts by penance and charitable works. Today we gather together to herald with the whole church the beginning of the celebration of our Lord's Paschal Mystery, that is to say, of his passion and resurrection. For it was to accomplish this mystery that he entered his own city of Jerusalem. Therefore, with all faith and devotion, let us commemorate the Lord's entry into the city for our salvation, following in his footsteps, so that being made by his grace partakers of the cross, we may have a share also in his resurrection and his life. Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, sanctify these branches with your blessing, that we who follow Christ the King in exaltation may reach the eternal Jerusalem through him, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke. Jesus proceeded on his journey up to Jerusalem. As he drew near to Bethpage and Bethany at the place called the Mount of Olives, he sent two of his disciples. He said, "Go into the village opposite you, and as you enter it, you will find a colt tethered on which no one has ever sat. Untie it and bring it here. And if anyone should ask you, 'Why are you untying it?' you will answer, 'The master has need of it.'" So those who had been sent went off and found everything just as he had told them. And as they were untying the colt, its owner said to them, "Why are you untying this colt?" They answered, "The master has need of it." So they brought it to Jesus, threw their cloaks over the colt, and helped Jesus to mount. As he rode along, the people were spreading their cloaks on the road. And now, as he was approaching the slope of the Mount of Olives, the whole multitude of his disciples began to praise God aloud with joy for all the mighty deeds they had seen. They proclaimed, "Blessed is the King who comes in the name of the Lord. Peace in heaven and glory in the highest." Some of the Pharisees in the crowd said to him, "Teacher, rebuke your disciples." He said in reply, "I tell you, if they keep silent, the stones will cry out." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Dear brothers and sisters, like the crowds who acclaimed Jesus to Jerusalem, let us go forth in peace.
Please join in singing number 402, "All Glory, Laud, and Honor."
Joined with all things created, make reply. All glory, laud, and honor.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, who as an example of humility for the human race to follow, caused our Savior to take flesh and submit to the cross, graciously grant that we may heed his lesson of patient suffering and so merit a share in his resurrection, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The Lord God has given me a well-trained tongue, that I might know how to speak to the weary, a word that will rouse them. Morning after morning, he opens my ear that I may hear, and I have not rebelled, have not turned back. I gave my back to those who beat me, my cheeks to those who plucked my beard. My face I did not shield from buffets and spitting. The Lord God is my help. Therefore, I am not disgraced. I have set my face like flint, knowing that I shall not be put to shame. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
My God, oh, why have you abandoned me? My God, oh, why have you abandoned me? All who see me laugh at me. They mock me and they shake their heads. He relied on the Lord. Let the Lord be his refuge. My God, oh, why have you abandoned me? As dogs around me, they circle me about, wounded me and pierced me, I can number all my bones. My God, oh, why have you abandoned?
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Christ Jesus, though he was in the form of God, did not regard equality with God something to be grasped. Rather, he emptied himself, taking the form of a slave, coming in human likeness, and found human in appearance, he humbled himself, becoming obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Because of this, God greatly exalted him and bestowed on him the name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bend, of those in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. The word of the Lord.
Thanks.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus, King of endless glory, Savior of the world, Savior of the world. Praise to you, Lord Jesus, King of endless glory, Savior of the world, Savior of the world. Christ was obedient unto death, even death on the wood of the cross. Praise to you, Lord Jesus, King of endless glory, Savior of the world, Savior of the world.
In order to more prayerfully reflect on the Passion, we invite you to please be seated. The Passion of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Luke. The elders of the people, chief priests and scribes, arose and brought Jesus before Pilate. They brought charges against him, saying,
"We found this man misleading our people. He opposes the payment of taxes to Caesar and maintains that he is Christ, a king."
Pilate asked him,
"Are you the king of the Jews?"
He said to him in reply,
"You say so."
Pilate then addressed the chief priests and the crowds,
"I find this man not guilty."
But they were adamant and said,
"He is inciting the people with his teaching throughout all of Judea, from Galilee where he began, even to here."
On hearing this, Pilate asked if the man was a Galilean, and upon learning that he was under Herod's jurisdiction, he sent him to Herod, who was in Jerusalem at the time. Herod was very glad to see Jesus. He had been wanting to see him for a long time, for he had heard about him and had been hoping to see him perform some sign. He questioned him at length, but he gave him no answer. The chief priests and scribes, meanwhile, stood by accusing him harshly. Herod and his soldiers treated him contemptuously and mocked him, and after clothing him in a resplendent garb, sent him back to Pilate. Herod and Pilate became friends that very day, even though they had been enemies formerly. Pilate then summoned the chief priests, the rulers, and the people, and said to them,
"You brought this man to me and accused him of inciting the people to revolt. I have conducted my investigation in your presence and have not found this man guilty of the charges you have brought against him. Nor did Herod, for he sent him back to us. So no capital crime has been committed by him. Therefore, I shall have him flogged and then release him."
But all together they shouted out,
"Away with this man. Release Barabbas to us."
Now Barabbas had been imprisoned for a rebellion that had taken place in the city, and for murder. Again, Pilate addressed them, still wishing to release Jesus, but they continued their shouting,
"Crucify him, crucify him."
Pilate addressed them a third time,
"What evil has this man done? I found him guilty of no capital crime. Therefore, I shall have him flogged and then release him."
With loud shouts, however, they persisted in calling for his crucifixion, and their voices prevailed. The verdict of Pilate was that their demand should be granted. So he released the man who had been imprisoned for rebellion and murder, for whom they asked, and handed over Jesus over to them to deal with as they wished. As they led him away, they took hold of a certain Simon, a Cyrenian, who was coming in from the country. And after laying the cross on him, they made him carry it behind Jesus. A large crowd of people followed Jesus, including many women, who mourned and lamented him. Jesus turned to them and said,
"Daughters of Jerusalem, do not weep for me. Weep instead for yourselves and for your children. For indeed the days are coming when people will say, 'Blessed are the barren, the wombs that never bore, and the breasts that never nursed.' At that time, people will say to the mountains, "Fall on us," and to the hills, "Cover us." For if these things are done when the wood is green, what will happen when it is dry?
Now two others, both criminals, were led away with him to be executed. When they came to the place called the Skull, they crucified him and the criminals there, one on his right, the other on his left. Then Jesus said,
"Father, forgive them. They know not what they do."
They divided his garments by casting lots. The people stood by and watched. The rulers, meanwhile, sneered at him and said,
"He saved others. Let him save himself if he is the chosen one, the Christ of God."
Even the soldiers jeered at him. As they approached to offer him wine, they called out,
"If you are King of the Jews, save yourself."
Above him, there was an inscription that read, "This is the King of the Jews." Now one of the criminals hanging there reviled Jesus, saying,
"Are you not the Christ? Save yourself and us."
The other, however, rebuked him, and in reply,
"Have you no fear of God? For you are subject to the same condemnation. And indeed, we have been condemned justly, for the sentence we received corresponds to our crimes. But this man has done nothing criminal."
Then he said,
"Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom."
He replied to him,
"Amen, I say to you, today you will be with me in paradise."
It was now about noon, and darkness came over the whole land until 3 p.m, because of an eclipse of the sun. Then the veil of the temple was torn down the middle. Jesus cried out in a loud voice,
"Father, into your hands I commend my spirit."
And when he had said this, he breathed his last.
Let us kneel. Let us stand.
The centurion who witnessed what had happened glorified God and said,
"This man was innocent beyond doubt."
When all the people who had gathered for this spectacle saw what had happened, they returned home, beating their breasts. But all his acquaintances stood at a distance, including the women who had followed him from Galilee and saw these events. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I've often wondered how the word got around that Jesus would be riding through Jerusalem on that Palm Sunday afternoon so many centuries ago. Obviously, folks weren't able to text or email. They couldn't make a phone call or send a fax. So how did the word get out? And more importantly, why were so many people eager to leave their home, travel a distance, and stand in line for many hours just to catch a glimpse of Jesus? Actually, the better and more pertinent question would be, would we be, all of us here, as willing and as able and as eager to do the same today? I know that we would, but I'd have to wonder, would we really take time out of our busy lives that seem so important to us to line the streets just to catch a glimpse of Jesus passing by? Would we call out his name and request a favor of him, maybe more? Would we wave our hands and cheer along with the crowd? Would we express our anger over an unanswered prayer? Or would we just stand there and shed a tear of joy after catching the eye of our Savior and King? My guess, my hope, is that you and I would be so awestruck by his presence and his spirit that we would not be able to move. We would not be able to speak. May that be our experience of Jesus this week even after 20 centuries have passed since that first Palm Sunday so long ago. Please join us in prayer on Holy Thursday, Good Friday, and Easter Sunday as we walk with Jesus through the anguish and suffering of Holy Week to the joy and the gladness of Easter. God bless you. Let us stand now and together profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. With every tongue we confess that Jesus is Lord, and so we have the courage to bring our prayers before him.
Please respond, hear our prayer. For God's people journeying to Jerusalem, may we faithfully accompany Jesus to his cross. Lord, in your mercy,
Hear our prayer.
For our human family, may all people extend to one another the mercy God has shown the whole world. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For those suffering pain, humiliation, or injustice, may they receive comfort and peace through their trust in God's love and care. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For this parish community, as we complete our Lenten journeys, may we be strengthened in faith, hope, and love as we gather to worship during this holy week. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For all who will gather for the communal celebration of forgiveness, for a respect for all life from conception to natural death, for an increase in vocations to the priesthood, diaconate, and religious life, for those serving our country and their loved ones, for the members of our parish prayer ministry, for our own prayers, and for all petitions written in our Book of Intentions, Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer. For the many victims of the war in Ukraine, for all those impacted by COVID-19, and for those who bring healing and
as we offer you these prayers in love and faith, lead us now to your Son's supper, to the foot of the cross, and to his glorious resurrection, that we may truly be your followers. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
As the gifts are prepared, please join in singing number 416, Were You There?
Were you there when abide, my Lord. Were you there when they crucified my Lord? Sometimes it causes me to tremble, tremble, tremble. Were you there when they crucified my Lord? Were you there when they nailed him to the tree? Were you there when they nailed him to the tree? Sometimes it causes me to tremble, tremble, tremble. Were you there when they nailed him to the tree?
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the cause of the Holy Church.
Through the passion of your only begotten Son, O Lord, may our reconciliation with you be near at hand, so that though we do not merit it by our own deeds, yet by this sacrifice made once for all, we may feel already the effects of your mercy. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For though innocent, he suffered willingly for sinners, and accepted unjust condemnation to save the guilty. His death has washed away our sins, and his resurrection has purchased our justification. And so with all the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them, like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection,
bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Joseph, our Bishop, the religious, the clergy, and your entire people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles, St. Teresa, St. Francis Cabrini, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Offer to one another a gesture of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Miserere nobis. Miserere nobis. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Miserere nobis. Miserere nobis. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Dona nobis pacem. Dona nobis pacem.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
An act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are
present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you.
Our communion song is number 415, O Sacred Head Surrounded.
O Sacred Head Surrounded by crown of piercing thorn, O bleeding head so wounded, reviled and put to scorn, the power of death comes o'er you, the glow of life decays. Yet angel hosts adore you and tremble as they gaze. I see your strength and vigor, all fading in the strife, and death with cruel rigor bereaving you of life. O agony and dying, O love to sinners free, Jesus, all grace applying, O turn your face on me. In this your bitter passion, Good Shepherd, think of me. With your most sweet compassion, unworthy though I be, beneath your cross abiding, forever would I rest. In your dear love confiding, and with your presence bless.
Please join in singing our second communion song, number 420, Behold the Wood.
Behold, behold the wood of the cross, on which is hung our salvation. O come, let us adore. Unless a grain of wheat shall fall upon the ground and die, it shall remain but a single grain, and not give life. Behold, behold, be the wood of the cross, on which is hung our salvation. O come, let us adore.
And when my hour of glory comes, as all was meant to be, you shall see me lifted up upon a tree.
Behold, behold, the wood of the cross, on which is hung our salvation. Oh, come, let us adore. Let
us pray. Nourished with these sacred gifts, we humbly beseech you, O Lord, that just as through the death of your Son you have brought us to hope for what we believe, so by his resurrection you may lead us to where you call. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go forth. The Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
As we are sent forth, we ask that you leave today in respectful silence as we begin this sacred Holy Week.